My name is Haley Elliott, and I'm a pre-sales solutions consultant for Workday Adaptive Planning here at Revelwood. Planning for pharmaceutical manufacturers is often complex and cumbersome, with the need to calculate gross to net revenue based on variables like chargebacks, rebates, and pharmacy-specific contract terms to account for ASC 606 regulations for recurring revenue for treatments for chronic conditions, and to consider market factors that address market share, TAMs, and payer composition. Workday Adaptive Planning resolves the inefficiency and error-prone process of maintaining all these variables in siloed spreadsheets. When pharmaceutical manufacturers leverage adaptive planning, they can expect a centralized, single source of truth that turns static, divided data into streamlined, collaborative models and dynamic visuals for on-the-fly scenario analysis. Today, we'll take a look at two examples of how pharmaceutical companies might use Workday Adaptive Planning to plan for gross to net revenue and inventory based on a consensus supply-demand plan. Let's start with gross to net modeling in one of our active dashboards. Here, you'll see a few key KPIs for our distribution channels, sales by prescription type, and a comparison of our total versus new prescriptions forecasted for the upcoming year. At the bottom here, we also have the base model for our sales forecast, starting with the projected number of patients, usually a calculated field based on a percent of market share of the total addressable market managed in our assumption sheets, which then moves into units per prescription and eventually down to our pricing, revenue, and standard cost metrics. With active dashboards, we might choose to look at a new scenario where we target a slightly more conservative growth target or market share in Q1 of our forecast. We'll save those changes and see all of the associated charts immediately update to reflect our new scenario. One way to take the step from our gross revenue to net revenue seen in that previous dashboard is by incorporating a payer mix or reimbursement schedule, such as the one shown here. While some clients choose to keep these assumptions at a higher payer level, you might choose to plan payer mix by including dimensions like state, payment method, or condition as well. Supplies, however, are constrained. Adaptive planning allows users to create a balanced revenue forecast by taking into account a constrained supply plan. The current sheet utilizes data for orders on hand, various operational metrics, and historical pricing and warehouse acquisition costs to calculate our inventory plan. Here, we start with the demand from our pharmacy network, and back into how much additional inventory will be needed from our factories or distribution centers. The warehouse inventory indicates months where we will fall short on being able to fulfill orders based on current capacity. These metrics then flow into both our sales summary here at the bottom, again using a gross to net process similar to what we saw earlier, and an active summary dashboard that displays anywhere our demand will outpace factory production. In the past few minutes, we've taken a very quick look at how Workday Adaptive Planning's flexible sheets and active dashboards can be leveraged in both several planning processes for pharmaceutical manufacturers. Reach out for a deep dive into what's behind these models and the efficiencies Adaptive can boost throughout your organization.